Now that we have our player object added to the layout, and we've set up the 8-direction behavior to be able to move our ship around, I'd like to add some enemies to the level so we have a way to die. What I'd like to do is add some asteroids that fly across the layout from the right side to the left side. Also, we're going to dynamically spawn these as time passes, so that we have an endless stream of asteroids coming at us. First, let's add a new sprite object to the layout. Double-click the screen, scroll down, and select Sprite under the General category. I'll name this sprite Asteroid, and click Insert. We want these asteroids to fly off the left side of the screen, so let's place it on the right side, right next to the edge of the layout. I've included a link to the image for this sprite in the description, so feel free to download it and select it here, or use your own art. Next, we need to add some behaviors to the asteroid object to get it performing the way we want it to. First, I want the asteroid to be spinning as it travels across the screen. Construct 3 has a behavior for this called the rotate behavior. The rotate behavior rotates an object around its origin point. Select the asteroid object and click on Behaviors. Let's add a new behavior. This time, we'll use the rotate behavior under the Movements category. If I preview the layout, the asteroid is stationary, but it's rotating. It's rotating a little too fast though, so let's slow it down a bit. Under the Rotate behavior, change the Speed property to 100. Preview the layout again, and it's looking better, but still too fast for me. Let's slow it down even further, to 75. Okay, that looks better. Now, we need to get the asteroid object moving across the screen. Since the asteroids are going to be traveling in one direction, we don't need something as complex as the 8-direction behavior. Construct 3 has a behavior that will work perfect for this situation, called the bullet behavior. The bullet behavior causes an object to travel forward at a specified rate of speed. Click Behaviors and add a new behavior. This time, we'll add the bullet behavior under the Movements category. If I preview the layout, the asteroid moves towards the right side of the screen, not the left. Not to mention, it's not traveling in a straight line like I said the bullet behavior does. The reason why is because we're using the bullet behavior in combination with the rotate behavior. If the object moves forward, it will move in the direction the object is facing. Remember, this right side is considered the front of the object. So when the rotate behavior rotates our object, it travels forwards, towards the direction which the sprite is facing. This is an easy fix though. There's a property under the bullet behavior called set angle. Just uncheck set angle. And as the asteroid rotates, its angle of motion will not change. If I preview the layout, you can see the asteroid now moves off the right side of the screen, going in a straight line. That's better, but still not quite what we want. We want the asteroid to travel towards the left side of the screen. We could just rotate the sprite in the editor and have it facing towards the left side of the layout, but we're going to be adding these asteroids dynamically, which means we'd have to change the angle in the event sheet for every new asteroid we create. A better way to do this would be to reverse the speed of the bullet behavior. Under the bullet behavior's properties, change speed from 400 to negative 400. Remember, the speed is moving the object forward at that many pixels per second. If the object is facing right and we add 400 pixels, it will move to the right. If we subtract 400 pixels per second, the object will travel towards the left, or backwards. There, that looks much better. It's still a bit too fast, though. Let's change the speed of the bullet behavior. I'll slow it down to negative 200 pixels per second. Now, when I preview the layout, the asteroid moves across the screen at negative 200 pixels per second, while rotating around its origin point. I'd like to add these asteroids to the layout dynamically, as time passes. That way, we don't just have one asteroid that flies by, we have many that fly by over the duration of the level. To do this, we need to make use of the event sheet. The event sheet is how we add events and actions to our game. Events are the way that Construct allows you to create complex game design without needing to write any code. The way it works is, we set up an event, which works like a trigger. When the event occurs, we perform an action on something in the layout. A simple example would be if we wanted the level to last for 60 seconds. After 60 seconds has passed, an event is fired. This event triggers an action, which could be to send the player to the next level, or to respawn enemies for another wave. Let's take a look at what I mean. Right now, we've got Layout 1 and Event Sheet 1 in our project bar. Every layout can have an event sheet attached to it. You can choose which event sheet your layout uses by selecting the layout in the project bar and then going to the event sheet property in the properties bar. To use the event sheet, we have to switch over to it by clicking on the Event Sheet 1 tab at the top of the layout editor. Here, we can add the events and actions that will specify how our game performs. Let's add our first event and see how it works. Click on Add Event, which brings up the Add Condition window. From here, we can choose which object we'd like to set up an event for. We can choose either the player object we added, or the asteroid object, or the system object. We'll be using the system object for now, so go ahead and double-click it. That takes us to a list of all of the available events for this object. There are a lot, so don't worry too much about all of this for now. Let's just get our first event up and running. I want to create a new asteroid, let's say every 5 seconds. Construct has an event that we can use, all the way at the bottom under the time category, called every X seconds. This event lets you choose a number of seconds, X, and then any actions placed under it will be fired off every X seconds. Select the every X seconds event and double-click it. Here, we can choose the number of seconds we want to pass before the event is fired off, and I'll use 5 seconds, and click Done. Now, we've got our first event, and we're able to add actions to it that will occur when this event is triggered. To do that, click on Add Action. We can choose which object we'd like to perform an action on, and again, I'll choose the System object. Here, we can select the action we want to be performed. What I want to do is spawn an asteroid. We can do that with Create Object, right here under the General category. I'll select Create Object and double-click it. Here, we choose which object we want to create, the XY coordinates where we want it to be placed, and the layer it will be placed on. First, let's choose an object, the asteroid object. Next is layer, which we haven't talked about yet. Don't worry about it for now, we'll cover layers later. But for the X and Y position, I want to have a look at the layout to determine where they should be. So for now, I'll just click Done, and we'll come back and change the XY values in a minute. If I switch back to the layout and select the asteroid object, we can take a look at its coordinates. I actually don't want it to start from here, so I'll move it back some. If I move it right up against the right edge of the layout, it will have an X position of 875. For the Y position, I want the asteroid to appear at a random position on the Y axis. The height of the layout is 600 pixels, so we need a random number between 0 and 600. Let's go back to the event sheet and fill in those values. To edit an event or action that you've already added to your event sheet, just double-click on it. Now, we can set the X position to 875. And under Y, we're going to use an expression. We'll cover expressions more later, but right now, I'll show you how to use an expression to get a random number. For the Y position, I'll enter random, followed by opening and closing parentheses. Inside of the parentheses, enter 600. What this does is pretty straightforward. It gives us a random value between 0 and 600. The number that we pass in here determines the maximum random number we can get. Since the layout is 600 pixels tall, we'll set the position to X875 and a random Y position between 0 and 600. Let's give it a try. When I load the layout, our original asteroid comes flying by. And after 5 seconds pass, another asteroid is spawned at X875 and at a random Y position. But we have two problems that we need to fix. To see what's going on with the first problem, we need to debug the layout. We'll talk more about debugging later, But debugging a layout is just like previewing it, except a bunch of information is contained under the viewport that helps us see what's going on while we play our level. To debug a layout, click the little arrow next to the preview button and select Debug Layout from the drop-down menu. There's a bunch of information here, so don't worry about most of it for now. All we're concerned with is the asteroid object under System. This number here is the number of asteroids in our layout. Every time an asteroid is spawned, that number goes up. If you click on Asteroid, it drops down to show you each instance of the asteroid that's contained in our layout. If I click on the first asteroid, we can see its X position. It's way off the screen, and it's still being calculated. The longer this runs, the more asteroids are spawned, with each one of them using up CPU resources to calculate its position. This can cause performance issues later if we don't do something to prevent it now. Construct 3 has a behavior that's made for this, called Destroy Outside Layout. It does exactly what it sounds like. It destroys the object when it's no longer visible on the screen, freeing up those resources. Go ahead and select the asteroid object. Click Behaviors, and add a new behavior. We want to use Destroy Outside Layout under the General category. Go ahead and add it. And the problem is solved. Now, let's debug again. And the total number of asteroids never rises above 1, since as soon as they leave the layout, they're destroyed. Okay, one last problem. When the asteroid is spawned, it's placed anywhere on the y-axis, from 0 to 600. But our asteroid object has its own height. It's 50 pixels tall. If I place the original asteroid at y0, only half of the asteroid would be visible. This is an easy fix as well. We need to put a little buffer area so that the asteroid isn't spawned in a place where it won't be completely visible. Let's switch back to the event sheet and double-click the Create Object action. With the random expression, if you pass in one value, like we do here, it gives a random number between 0 and the number passed in. But we can pass in two numbers, separated by a comma, and the first number will be the lowest possible random number, while the second will be the highest possible random number. We don't want our asteroids to be placed any less than Y25, since the asteroid is 50 pixels tall and the origin point is in the center of the sprite. So, the first number will be 25, and the second number will be the height of the layout, 600 pixels, minus 25 pixels, half of the asteroid's height. So, I'll pass in 575 for the second value. Now, this random expression will return a value of between 25 and 575. I'll just move this first asteroid off the screen, so it's destroyed right away. I only want the dynamically spawned asteroids to appear. I'll preview it again. And everything's working properly. After 5 seconds, a new asteroid is dynamically spawned and destroyed once it leaves the layout.